Well, we come to you from the Anna University, where more than 300 children are in the process of creating a micro forest on campus. But what's special, they are using robots to plant these 300 plus saplings. The management has given them this particular patch of land, and in 3 months' time, they hope this will all shoot up and a brand new forest will be created. Thank you all very much for your time. How important is creation of green cover like this?
This is like making the earth excited. The earth will become green. Now it is very dried, so we are planting trees to make the earth little greenish.
Right. And using robots to plant these saplings, what's the message?
Well, actually, we should start using technology in the right way. Instead of making PS4, PS5, PS6, we need to start utilizing it for something that people actually need, like farmers. They work in the hot sun every day, and all they get paid is like very little, and we need to help them by making something which will, like, you know, farm or like.
And robotics can help in fighting global warming?
Yes, robotics can help in fighting global warming. We just made a world record, and for others it will seem like a world record, but we know that we are doing something to help this planet. And if we don't act fast, then as everyone says, the greenery is going to end, but no one actually does something. But we have taken it a step further, and we have thought of an idea in which we can actually help the planet and not just say, okay, let's eradicate.
Right. In fact, they are trying to set a world record, and you're all interested in robotics. Yes. When you grow up, when you study much about this, yeah, what kind of a problem you want to solve?
I want to solve some problems that we can, more problems, but we can solve these problems through robotics. That I want to prove. Such an example is in space, we can have, we all know that, satellite traffic. For the clear that, we can send some robots like human shape and destroy some weird satellites and clear the space.
And see, there's a challenge of children getting trapped in bore wells. Do you think robotics can find a solution for that?
Yes. So, we can have a machine which we can take, easily a child without no problem. Like, how can I tell you? A wing, a round shaped thing which we have a string which we can attach to a machine or something which the child.
Will you work on that?
Yes, sir. I'll do it.
Right. Many would also say robotics and artificial intelligence in the long run could actually take away jobs.
No, sir.
Yes, that's true, because robotics is going to a very big level, and everyone keeps inventing more robots, like the waiter robot that was invented recently. This sometimes goes to a very big extent, and Stephen Hawking has already said that if we don't act fast, then robotics will take over the world by improving themselves.
How challenging, interesting, fun was using a robot to plant the sapling?
It was exciting, because instead of using the farmers to plant, we are using the robots. So pick and place, we can also use it for many things, not only for planting trees. If a granny, her leg is paining, she can't walk, she can control with this robot. And even I couldn't take my socks and put it in the basket, we can let the robot take it and pick it and put it in the basket.
Recently, Australia had bushfires.
Yes.
Do you think robotics can help?
Yeah, we can help with that water pouring robot, because it will be, we can control with not only this pick and place robot, we can control with an advanced level robot with fire sensor. Where will be a fire, we can use to program that and use to pour that water where is the fire.
There are many challenges, like little children getting trapped inside bore wells. Are you also training these kids to perhaps find solutions for these problems?
In fact, absolutely. So today, makers have come together against global warming because they personally feel connected towards solving that problem, right? So in fact, at every course that we teach, right, we actually empower our makers to actually find solutions for all the problems out there, right? So, you know, be it, you know, home automation, or even be it, you know, as you said, you know, rescue of children or rescue of humans who are trapped in bore wells. So we actually encourage our makers chance to find out solutions for all these problems.
Will robotics, AI take away jobs in the future?
In fact, it will actually aid them. So the thing is, if you see any job, right, where you have an emotional connect, we know that humans can never be replaced with robots, right? In fact, AI engineers and robotic engineers are going to be hunted after or sought after, rather than it actually replacing jobs. Only the manual jobs, which are going to be completely repetitive, only they might have a possibility of replacement.
Thank you so much for your time, and certainly an inspirational attempt, children creating a forest using robotics, and perhaps this could inspire many more to use technology, robotics, to increase green cover, to fight global warming, and also perhaps to find solutions for many challenges. In Chennai with Suresh, Sam Daniel, 5 NDTV.